As always, time to talk some Earlham men's basketball with head coach Jason Polykoff. Quakers lost a couple of tough ones last week, one of those in overtime right here at the Athletics and Wellness Center. And now they'll travel to Transylvania as of this taping on Wednesday, and then on the road at Franklin coming up on Saturday. And coach, I'll tell you what, the way you guys played in those last two games, and just so close for your ball club, I was just pulling for you every step of the way. But go back to those two losses, and it's a team now that when you start watching, I think they're starting to get it a little bit, aren't they?
Yeah, and I think that's the part that's exciting for me, and I know what's exciting for them is when you're struggling to win games, you got to look at some other X factors, and that is, are we getting better?
Yeah.
Are we improving, not only individually but collectively? And I do honestly believe we're getting better. And now I see it in practice. Mm-hmm. It wasn't always demonstrated in the games. Now we're starting to see it in the games as well.
Yeah.
You look back at this game on Saturday against Manchester. I mean, we went to their place and they took care of us.
Yeah.
And they really did. They took it to us, but we looked at the film, we watched the film, we analyzed it, and really a lot of it was just us.
Yeah.
You know, we didn't play with the energy and the effort we need to, and the execution was poor, and we made our adjustments, we fixed some things, and obviously we took them down to the wire. We believe we should have won, but it's okay. We learn from our games.
You know, the other day, and I've got to mention this, after one of your games, I was watching, we were doing our post-game information, and Elijah Wilson Thomas was out shooting, and he was out there all by himself. And I thought that was a great sign, because I know he's one of those players you really need to step up on both ends of the floor, but really offensively, because he's a scorer.
Yeah.
But it was good to see him out there shooting, and again, nobody else around.
Yep. No, I mean, that's one thing that our guys never falter. They're going to work hard.
Yeah.
They're going to work hard and try to improve. He's a perfect example of that. He was not pleased with the way he shot the ball that game, so he got right back in the gym to correct some things, and worked out for him against Manchester. Our big thing with Elijah is we want to let the game come to him. There are times he knows he can score.
Right.
And there are some times where he tries to make too much happen.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes from a good place. It's not because he's a selfish player by any stretch. He's just trying to make something happen for the team. And when you push too hard, sometimes it can push back against you.
Yeah.
What we're doing a much better job now is sharing the ball, making the extra pass, finding the open guys. And Manchester is a perfect example of that, where he got off early because our guys made the extra pass to get him an open shot.
Yeah.
He didn't have to force a shot. And when he saw one or two go in, that's all he needs.
Yeah.
And when he's open, it's going to go in most of the time. His free throw percentage is a perfect example of that.
Bet.
If he's forcing and trying to do too much, it doesn't look as good.
Yeah.
And that's what he's learning. And, he made some great plays, and so did our senior Taylen Alexander. And I was really, really pleased with our point guard play.
Yeah.
By our freshman Isaiah Ware.
Yeah.
Everybody that stepped into the game played their tails off, and that's what made it, such a close game.
Well, Coach, I'm sure anxious now to get back to work as the Quakers will head to Transylvania.
Yep.
Two straight road games. Talk a little bit about tonight's matchup, and then, of course, on the road on Saturday.
Well, tonight we're at Transylvania. The first thing is we are not a terrific road team.
Okay.
We tend to not come out with enough energy enough that we need to compete. And that's all we've been talking about is tonight we got to come out with the energy. We know our X's and O's. We know the principles. We know what we're supposed to be doing. It's, can we match or exceed their energy?
Yeah.
And so that's the first thing we're anticipating, that we're going to come out with some energy. I'm anticipating we'll come out with some energy. Then just feeding off of how we played last time or on Saturday against Manchester, just sharing the ball, playing hard, playing correct defense, all the things that put us in that game in a position to win. And then we look back to the last time we played Transylvania here, and it was one of those games, just like the first time we played Manchester, where we felt we gave it up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to take anything away from Transylvania, but we just didn't play the way we know we're capable of playing.
Yeah.
And if we play that way, like we did against Manchester on Saturday, we'll be in position to win the game.
I know you're focused on tonight, but then it's always tough going to Franklin, playing down there.
Yeah. Now, Franklin's in the same boat as we are. They're having a tough season. Yeah. But they have some good players. One's a junior and one's a senior. And whenever you have experienced players who are good, it's going to be a tough battle. So, again, I'm not thinking too much ahead to that game, but I am, you know, I do believe that game will be a dogfight. And at Franklin is always tough, like you said, yeah. and you know, we'll see what happens.
Coach, good luck in the next two games.
Thank you. Appreciate it, Troy.
Of course, again, the Quakers will be on the road, Transylvania on Wednesday, and then Franklin coming up on Saturday. We'll talk with Coach Polykoff coming up again next week right here on Radio Troy Digital Sports.